Good evening. I am Ruthie Brock, student body president of Clinton High School, and I am honored to welcome all graduates, parents, and loved ones watching at home to Clinton High School's Class of 2020 virtual baccalaureate service.
Good evening, Class of 2020, parents, family, and friends. Good times become good memories, and bad times become good lessons. So to the class of 2020, I say thank you. Thank you for allowing us to share the good times and the bad times with you. The good memories, the good lessons, in other words, the life experiences we have shared provided many memories and lessons learned. And what a unique life experience 2020 has been. It is amazing what life sometimes throws at you when you least expect it. You, the class of 2020, your families, your educators, well, all of us are in the middle of the COVID-19 pandemic. Everything has changed. And oh, at times we feel fearful and confused about the potential deadly virus. But what about our lives, our plans? Oh, the disappointment, the anger and frustration. The questions, why? Why me? Why now? We cry out, this is not fair. And as seniors, you feel as if your last year was taken from you. Let me assure you, we are truly hurt for you and with you. As a mother, I want to wrap my arms around you and say, it's going to be all right. But as your principal, I feel the need to say to you, you are right. Life is not always fair. And in your lifetime, you will face trials and hardships. But the most valuable life lessons come not from teachers or textbooks, but from life experiences. The unfair times, the painful times. The greatest things I know came through mistakes, failures, and disappointments. My prayer for you is that when you are having a bad time, that you remember that you are never alone. There is a higher power greater than ourselves or any bad time we may experience. Just keep your eyes on Him. Develop an attitude of gratitude and be grateful in all times, good or bad. For before you are all your dreams. Speaking of dreams, did you know that Oprah referred to you, the class of 2020, as the chosen class? And I quote, the chosen class for such a time as this. She also stated, never has a graduating class been called to step into the future with more purpose, vision, passion, energy, and hope. If I may, I would like to expand on Oprah's comment. You see, I believe each of you were chosen long before you were born. You are unique, but most importantly, you are loved. And within you is all you need. Therefore, I challenge you to not let COVID-19 define who you are. You are the Clinton High School class of 2020. I encourage you to focus on all the positives and all the possibilities ahead. Be proud and grateful as you remember how your families, friends, members of the community, school educators, and administration rallied together to do everything in their power to make this a special, memorable event for you. For around you are all who love you. So what was the lesson learned from this life experience? First, life is 10% what happens to you and 90% how you react to it. Therefore, you are capable of changing things in your life. Second, tough times don't last. Tough people do. Therefore, you are capable of overcoming anything that's standing in your way. Third, life is full of challenges. But these challenges are only given to you because your faith is strong enough to get you through them. Therefore, you are capable of dealing with adverse circumstances and going through whatever life throws at you. Fourth, you are strong, courageous, and loved. Therefore, you have arrived because you stuck together, champions, one and all. I close with the Dr. Seuss quote, "Kid, you'll move mountains. Today is your day. Your mountain is waiting, so get on your way. Congratulations, and God bless the class of 2020.
Good evening. I'm Kaylee Yang, Student Body Vice President of Clinton High School, and I have the distinct privilege to introduce our guest speaker this evening, Pastor Russ Emanuel. Pastor Emanuel is no stranger to all of us, as he is a current member of the Clinton City Schools Board of Education, pastor of Olive Grove Church here in Clinton, and a Clinton High School graduate. Pastor Emanuel and his wife Chrissy are proud parents of 5 children, and they're extremely active in our community and are always willing to do whatever it takes to help the students and the community. We are indeed privileged and blessed to have him deliver a message to the class of 2020.
Hello, class of 2020, and greetings to our Dark Horse Nation. I'm grateful to be a part of such an innovative experience. I want to thank everyone who has worked so diligently to make this possible. So I understand that we can experience somewhat of a deficit whenever we're viewing online because of the distractions that will kind of quickly allow us to be removed from what's going on. So I didn't design a farewell speech for you. Actually, what I want to do is I want to speak into your future. So let me pray for our time together. God, we honor you today. Father, we thank you for this amazing group of seniors that we're about to celebrate. We celebrate what they have achieved, but we also celebrate the journey that lies ahead. We stand now in your presence, God, to be able to celebrate what's next. So may they always acknowledge you in all of their ways. As you said in your word, you would direct their paths. So may your word be a lamp unto their feet that builds their faith on the journey, in Jesus' name. I want to tell you that I am absolutely honored to have this opportunity to speak to this generation of leaders. And notice that I didn't say the next generation of leaders, because you guys are leading right now. You're leaders in a very unusual, during uncertain and actually unprecedented times and circumstances. So you're a unique group, and you're facing a unique set of circumstances. So nothing you have experienced over the last couple of months is anything normal. So the end of your school year wasn't normal. This service is not normal. Your graduation is unlike one that I experienced as a dark horse. You're graduating in the middle of a pandemic. Actually, you're the only generation alive that actually knows what that even feels like. So which tells me that, to me, this is an indicator that you're marked for greatness, because obstacles have become opportunities, and they've become those opportunities to prove your perseverance. I want to tell you that as a dark horse, you are built to persevere. So from one dark horse to another, I celebrate your achievements and your accomplishments. And I want to tell you that you are on the threshold of a monumental transition. This period in your life, and as you're transitioning, I want to let you know that oftentimes we can wonder about what's going to be next. What's the next normal? Everyone has a next step to take. For some of you, it's going to seem like a small step. For some of you, that next step is going to be scary. For some of you, that next step might even be a safe step. But one thing I want to remind you of today is, regardless the size of the next step that you have to take, you don't have to face it alone. The relationships that you have forged here within the Dark Horse community and within this family have made you a support system to be able to believe and belong throughout the years. One thing I know about families is that we face things together. So, class of 2020, your success is our honor. And regardless of what's next, we want to let you know that we're better together. So be encouraged and be empowered in knowing that we're willing to do whatever it takes to make sure that you succeed. So if you feel like you're in a situation or you feel like you're in a place where you don't have what it takes, you feel inadequate, you feel insecure, I want to provide you with a clear perspective today through a passage of scripture that will remind you to know that you can win with what you have. So class of 2020, you have what it takes because God put it in you. And God will never give you a project without equipping you with the tools to be able to perform it. The story that I'm talking about is in 1 Samuel chapter 16. And it kind of describes what's next as a young man by the name of David is in a transition period. So I want to read a couple of verses of scripture there for you in 1 Samuel 16 verses 1 through 4. And verse 1 says, "The Lord said to Samuel, how long will you mourn for Saul?" Saul was the current king of Israel. And he says, "Since I have rejected him as king over Israel." This is the prophet Samuel having a conversation with God. And God gives him some instructions. And he says, "Fill your horn with oil and be on your way. I'm sending you to Jesse of Bethlehem. I've chosen one of his sons to be king." But Samuel said, "How can I go? If Saul hears about what's going to take place, he will kill me." Then the Lord says, "Take your heifer with you and say, I have come to sacrifice to the Lord." I want to let you know, class of 2020, this is really important right here. There are going to be times in your journey where you just have to grab your heifer and go. That's what he tells the prophet. He says, "Grab your heifer and go." Verse 3 says, "Invite Jesse to the sacrifice and I will show you what to do. You are to anoint for me the one I indicate." This is verse 4, my favorite verse of this passage. So Samuel did as the Lord instructed. If we could just learn to do what the Lord says, it would oftentimes eliminate a lot of the frustration that we feel from trying to pursue our plan over God's purpose. So I kind of titled a message for you today, "Created to Win." Come on, let's say that together. I was created to win. In a time when I should be worrying, I want to let you know that you're going to be winning. Created in the image of the Creator. God has a plan for your life. You're not a mistake. You were fearfully and wonderfully made. And even whenever you are in uncertain circumstances and situations like we're in, you need to know that you have an assignment to accomplish. In fact, Scripture tells us that, "I know the plans that I have for you, says the Lord. Plans to do you good and not evil, plans to prosper you and to give you an expected future." You need to know that God has appointed you to accomplish an assignment. But in the assignment, it comes with the process. And oftentimes we want to skip the process because we're looking at the produce. We want to see the finished product, right? So you can't skip the process and go straight to the product because your process has a purpose. And from the time that David was anointed to be the next king until he was actually appointed was around 13 years. So that shows you that the process has a purpose. It was a process. In fact, David was anointed to be king, but after he was anointed to be king, he went back into a shepherd field. He went back to shepherding sheep just like he had always done. But in his journey, it didn't come without problems. In fact, one of the problems that I see in this scripture is that he wasn't even invited to the anointing party that was taking place. Your journey will not be problem-free. And I think you already know that. There will be times when you face problems, but I want to encourage you today, don't give up on your purpose. Endure the process. There is progress in the process, class of 2020, even in the middle of a pandemic. So let your problems become the very thing that propel you to focus on your purpose, because God has a plan and you have a purpose. You were created on purpose for a purpose. That's good news to know that you were created specifically, intentionally by God for a purpose. They say that people believe very little about what others say about them, but they believe everything that they say about themselves. So I want you to say this with me. I want you to speak this over your own life. I have an assignment and I am appointed. David was anointed to be king, but he was also appointed by the prophet Samuel. Now, if anointing sounds like a real churchy term for you, really it's not. So let me just kind of give you a clear perspective and kind of load up this phrase of what it really means to be anointed. Anointed means to be separated for God's service, to be singled out for special favor and responsibility. See, Christ is not Jesus' last name. Christ means the anointed one. So when we see that, it's actually Jesus, the anointed one. Just like you, David was picked by God, and David was picked to be the next king, even though he wasn't invited to the party. In fact, they were holding this party, and Samuel just knew that whenever the first son came forward, that he was supposed to be the next king. And he goes through all of Jesse's sons, and then he looks at Jesse and he says, "Is this all you got? You don't have anything other than this?" And he looks back and responds, Jesse does, to the prophet, and he says, "Well, I got one more. I got one more son. He's kind of out in the pasture. He's taking care of the family duties. He's shepherding sheep." So David wasn't even viewed to be valuable enough to receive the anointing party invitation. But even when you're not visible in the eyes of others, can I tell you that God views you as valuable? In fact, write this down. This is some refrigerator material for you. Just because I'm not visible doesn't mean I'm not valuable. See, we live in a digital age and an era where it's filled with screenshots, snaps, and stories. Everything is seen. But God doesn't determine value by visibility. Maybe that's why he's not made you visible in the eyes of others, because you're actually so valuable. Class of 2020, you may feel like you're invisible because you're having a virtual baccalaureate service. But just because this is virtual doesn't mean it's not valuable. See, God's perspective is not like men. And contrary to what the text looks like on the surface that we just read to you, David was not overlooked. He was actually hidden by God. See, because you hide what's valuable, right? We have 5 children, 4 boys and 1 girl, as Kayla just mentioned earlier in the introduction. Can I tell you that when they were growing up in our house, some of them are older and they're no longer in the house with us, but when they were growing up, especially those oldest 3, they were anointed by God to be able to have the ability to eat everything in sight. They didn't stop either until it was gone. And I learned during that time that if there was any kind of snack that I wanted to be able to enjoy later on, I had to learn how to hide it. I had to learn how to put it somewhere where they couldn't find it. Because you put away what you put out what you want people to have, but you put back what you want to preserve. See, the less visible, oftentimes, the more valuable. So I'd like to declare over this class that your visibility over the last 9 weeks may have been reduced, but when you are not being in a place, you're not in a place where you're being overlooked. You are actually hidden, because your value is not determined by your visibility. See, David was hidden in a field to shepherd sheep because he was valuable. You might feel as if you've been overlooked, unnoticed, invisible, and possibly even left out. But invisibility, contrary to popular opinion, is not a sign of insignificance. See, when God knows who you are, no one else has to know where you are. Because if God knows who you are, he will put the people in your life to let them know where you are. Maybe your lack of visibility is God saving you for something special. In fact, invisibility is not a sign of insignificance. See, all you see is me in front of a camera right now. But what you don't see are the people who are behind the scenes operating to make sure that the lights work, to make sure the audio is correct. Just because you don't see them doesn't mean that they're not valuable. They're not visible, but they are valuable. So it's the things oftentimes that no one sees that produces the results that everyone wants. In fact, when people make things look easy, it's really because they work at it. You get good grades because you do the work, right? You get the promotion, the pay increase, because you do the work. And I believe when you step into your assignment, you should actually learn to sharpen your skill set, whatever that is, whatever your next step is going to be, whether you're going to join the workforce, whether you're going into the armed forces, whether you're going to a community college or a four-year university, whatever you do, whatever your next step entails, whatever your next chapter, whatever is next in your journey, be good at what you do. Work at it. See, what made David fit to face Goliath were the fights with the lion and the bear in the shepherd fields. As I said earlier, it's oftentimes what you don't see. So let's say it together. Let's make this declaration together. Just because I'm not visible doesn't mean I'm not valuable. David wasn't invited to the anointing party because he was out sharpening his gift while he was shepherding sheep. And read the story. See, because what we know about David is David could swing a sling and he could play those strings. He was an awesome dude. I mean, he could beat you on the battlefield and then play a harp at your funeral. See, your gift will always make room for you. You do the work and then allow God to open the doors. I want to tell you a quick story about me personally. I was appointed to serve on your Clinton City School Board of Education. Not because I was out trying to prove that I have what it takes, because I believe that there are many that are far more qualified than I am. But what I learned in that process is that I was just out doing my thing, doing what God had called me to do. I believe that I pastor a city, not just a church. I was just out serving this community. And just like David, David didn't ask to be the next king. He was actually appointed. You need to know that God has an appointment for you. In fact, I never imagined the impact that God would allow me to have on this city when I sat where you're sitting over 31 years ago. I know it doesn't look like it's been that long, but it actually has. I had no idea that I would be doing what I'm doing right now. But you know what? God did, because he has a plan. Now I want you to know today, class of 2020, that God has appointed you with an assignment. And he's given you the ability to be able to accomplish what he has assigned for you. There might be some good choices along the way. You know what? There might be even some bad choices. But if you know the life of David, even he made some bad choices. But God has the power to take our bad choices and use them to benefit us. In fact, I know this to be true because Romans 8 and 28 says, "For we know that all things work together for good to those who are called according to his purpose." So you have a purpose. Doesn't say that everything is always going to be good. You might be facing some difficult times. You might feel like everything is falling apart around you. But can I tell you that having this virtual service was probably not part of your plans when you started your senior year? You're actually in the middle of a pandemic. That wasn't a part of the plan for any of us. But I want to tell you that even during these times, God can take these situations and work them for our good. So I want to declare a blessing of the favor of God on your life as a result of the finished work of Jesus. May you accomplish all the good things that he's planned for you before the foundations of the earth were ever made, before the foundations of the world were ever formed. God said he had a plan for you. In fact, he told the prophet Jeremiah that before the foundations were ever formed, I knew you in your mother's womb. Before you were ever there, I knew you. So God has a plan for your life. He didn't create you and then try to figure out what the plan was going to be for you. No, he had the plan in advance. So I just want to let you know today, class of 2020, that you are appointed, you are anointed, you have an assignment, you are valuable, you were created to win. It's your choice. You get to choose. So in my closing, I just want to tell you that I love you all. I'm so proud of everything that you have accomplished. Dark Horse Strong. Go Horses.
Thank you for joining our baccalaureate service. Let us pray. Dear God, we pray for our graduates today, and we thank you so much for those we love and for the work you are continuing to do in our lives. And during this season of new beginnings, we ask that you would make their way clear. May they sense your spirit over their lives in amazing ways, and may they be strengthened, instilled with hope for the new roads you have in store. Our world is currently anxious, fearful, and uncertain. We pray our graduates are filled with your courage and strength, and they may be a light to their friends and neighbors in this uncertain time. We ask for your peace to cover them. We ask for laughter and joy to fill their days. We pray that you would give them boldness and courage to face challenges set before them with the confidence and peace you can only come from your spirit. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.